So, what's up, guys? So, I got into a Facebook debate that I just wanted to briefly talk to you guys about this little experience. I forgot exactly what the name of the page was. I believe it was like People for Taking Our Country Back or something like that. And basically, as you would imagine, this is a bunch of like very, you know, Donald Trump-like supporter, middle-class sort of assholes and stuff like that. And, of course, white folks. These are people that not only denied white privilege existed, which is just stupid and ignorant in its own self, but are part of the group of folks that basically thought that Beyonce's Super Bowl performance was an attack on the police and was basically racist, because essentially what happened was she and her dancers were seen first of all, were allegedly supporting Black Lives Matter, which obviously being a black celebrity, she's inclined to do, and there's no issue about that. The other issue that they had was the fact that she allegedly was supporting the Black Panthers, because she and her supporters were holding up the raised fist. First of all, I informed these people that the raised fist is not a symbol of black empowerment. It is not, well, what it is. It was a symbol that was adopted by Huey Newton and the Black Panthers back in the 1960s. The reason for this was because that Huey Newton and Bobby Seale were revolutionary socialists. They were Marxists. They were Maoists. They were fighting for the race struggle, essentially the class struggle, to bring down the product of race struggle, gender struggle, etc. So basically, being revolutionaries themselves, they adopted the revolutionary symbol, which is the raised fist. This has always been the symbol of the workers' struggle, the workers of the world unite sort of thing. Now, of course, there's also been a debate amongst African Americans and people that don't seem to understand what that is. But that is what this symbol represents. This symbol was an old revolutionary symbol, an old workers and labor union symbol of protest. It was essentially saying that we are the workers of the world. We are fighting against, for our rights against the, you know, against the oppressing, you know, the oppressor, the, you know, the capitalist class. And that's essentially what that symbol has always meant. That's always what it has come to mean. Now, again, Huey Newton and Bobby Seale, they used this symbol as part of the Black Empowerment Movement, as part of the Black Panther Movement. Now, with that said, they were trying to say that basically supporting the Black Panthers is basically being racist and being anti-white. And of course, as you can imagine, I was called anti-white because, you know, white privilege and white colonizer and white supremacist thinking is that if you're pro-black or support black rights, you are automatically anti-white. The same sort of rhetoric I've gotten from neo-Nazi parties, neo-Nazi organizations like Stormfront and the Boers of South Africa, and of course the traditionalist white knights of the Ku Klux Klan. You know, it's that same rhetoric. Anybody that basically disagrees with your line of thinking, that disagrees with, you know, the Black Lives Matter, that disagrees with, that hates the Black Panther Party, basically calls you, basically is an impediment to to black rights and black civil rights and stuff like that, you're automatically called anti-white, because they're the ones that call you anti-white because, you know, reasons. But, and then I continued to explain to them what the difference was, that the Black Panthers were not a racist organization. The new Black Panthers are, and the new Black Panthers have been called out by none other than Bobby Seale and the Huey Newton Foundation. They've been, the new Black Panthers have been called out as racist, xenophobic, and anti-Semitic. This organization does not represent anything or any of the values, or nor do they have any right to the symbology of the old Black Panther Party, or the old guard, if you will, the OG. They do not represent that organization. The new Black Panther Party is a fascist organization. I did a video, which I will link in the description, last year, that basically explained the differences between the old guard and the new Black Panther Party, as well as the differences between black separatism, black nationalism, and black supremacy. So I basically covered all bases in that video. But I basically was explaining how the old guard Black Panthers were revolutionaries. They were the ones that actually supported equal opportunity, racial equality, and basically bringing everyone together against the, you know, against the capitalist class, essentially to break down the class struggle and to essentially create an equal opportunity society. The new Black Panthers do not represent that. The new Black Panthers basically want to, they basically are black supremacists. The new Black Panthers are ardently racist. In fact, not just ardently, they just plainly don't even hold their racism back. They are anti-Semitic. They don't hold that back. And they're very sly about how they go about saying things, but it's very obvious that the new Black Panthers and the old guard Black Panthers could be farther apart ideologically and are definitely two completely different organizations. So, in my defense, basically in my defense of the old guard Black Panthers and explaining how the new Black Panthers are fascist, I was called anti-white, and I was basically accused of living in a fantasy world, to which I responded that I was living in reality, and that the people and that the person who claimed I was living in a fantasy world was actually living in a bubble of ignorance. I have this conversation. I'm clearly winning the debate. I clearly know what I'm talking about, because obviously I've studied these two groups. I know my political ideologies. I know the political ideologies of these two organizations. I think I've pretty much got it down pat about what's going on. So after explaining all of this to them, after basically educating them on what's what, and clearly winning the argument, I was preparing another comment to send to another user, to another individual. But I was unable to do so because the page happened to have removed the post. So basically backed into a corner and losing the argument horribly, their members losing the argument horribly, resorted to a cowardly act of tucking their tails between their legs and running. Instead of engaging me in an honest, intelligent debate, they strawmanned, they basically committed red herring, and they basically just outright insulted me. or ad hominem, if you will, as a more an intellectual way of putting it. So basically, they just resorted to name-calling and all that, and then, of course, deleted the posts. Deleted the entire post. But not before I had gotten 80-plus likes in an hour for the honest commentary that I provided about the Black Panthers and the new Black Panthers. So, clearly winning the argument, they decided that they would just delete the post. I think that that's kind of an interesting way of how that all transpired. Instead of, again, engaging me in an intelligent, honest debate, they ran like cowards. I think that really shows the level of integrity that these individuals have. That they are willing to deny white privilege exists. They're willing to claim that Beyonce is racist because she supports the Black Panther Party. And clearly not knowing what the difference between the Black Panther Party and the new Black Panther Party is, or probably even what the Black Panthers in general are, these people end up making these stupid, ludicrous statements and get pwned tremendously. Just get pwned successfully. And they couldn't take it. They did not have an intellectual thing to say about it. So, in response, I just thought I would make this video talking about that little scenario that went down, because I thought it was pretty interesting, and I think it was pretty freaking cowardly that they decided to basically tuck their tails between their legs and run for the hills. Because clearly, someone more educated, who knows what the hell they're talking about, actually won that argument. But instead of admitting engaging in an intelligent conversation, or simply admitting defeat, they decided to take the coward's way out. So, you know what? Whatever. So, thank you guys for listening to this little interesting argument. I, again, will be posting that link to that video that I did last year, so you are free to watch that. It's 24 minutes long, so bear with it. But until next time, I'm NorCal Nick, leader of the revolutionist movement, and this has been NorCal Corner. Peace.